amazing land of ours, a magnificent empire created in the mind of a man who wrote a great book about it. Like wildfire in the wheat field, the fabulous tale of the Wizard of Oz spread from town to city to nation to the entire world.
The Wizard of Oz. More people have seen it than any other movie. Over a billion of them. It's probably the most beloved movie ever made in any language.
Vamos, venga a pelear. ¿Quién será el primero? Pelearé con los dos, si quieren.
Oiga, váyase y déjenos en paz.
Asustado, ¿eh? ¿Tienes miedo? No estás a gusto metido en esa lata.
Of the Wizard of Oz touches not only our children, but the child in all of us. The enchantment is easy to explain. The movie's sentiments are universal, its timelessness that of any great classic. Those who created this work came as near to perfection as anyone could ask. I first saw The Wizard of Oz as a schoolgirl in London, and I thought it was unlike anything that I'd ever seen before. It was so innovative. Such great fun. Later, when I began to watch it on television with my children and then my grandchildren, with each viewing, I realized that indeed this is a very special motion picture. A movie filled with values that we all cherish. A movie for all of us, for all time. This is part of a missing number from The Wizard of Oz. Why it is missing will be explained as we share the reminiscences of many who were part of the fascinating history of Oz. Backstage, there was confusion, chaos, and often danger. Now, for the first time, you're going to learn this remarkable story told by those who participated in the making of a movie classic.
They didn't want to do that, believe me, to spend that much money. Because that was a lot of money in those days, $2.6 million. A lot of money. They almost fired me for spending so much money.
We finally took some of the makeup off. They took some of the makeup off, and we went to the commissary. And it was such a frightening thing to see for other people, because what we looked like were people from another world, were those weird kind of faces that we had. And they just kicked us out of the commissary and made us eat in the dressing room.
People question me like you're questioning me now. So it must have been fun making that picture. It was not fun like hell. It was fun. It was a lot of hard work. It was not fun at all. There's nothing funny about it.
I had to work with three very professional men, you know, Jack Haley and Burr Bauer and Ray Bolger. And they had so much makeup on. And they were so busy complaining about their makeups. And each one was making bets as to which makeup was the most difficult always in the picture.
I thought that she was the most adorable creature that was ever put on this earth, and so right for the part of Dorothy. She was just like a little girl from Kansas, with great big eyes. She wasn't pretty, just plump, but in a way she was beautiful.
I'm frightened, Daddy, am I frightened?
I think she holds the whole picture together. Her sincerity that she wants to get back to Kansas. You believe her. She wants to get home to her Aunt Em and so forth. And that was the whole hub of the picture. But it's a wonderful picture. We're proud of it.
The one thing that we will be known for, no matter what we've done anyplace else in the whole world, will be The Wizard of Oz. Well, we don't get any residuals, but we have a better thing than residuals. We have a kind of immortality. And a great pride for being a part of a great American classic.
You have to see the Wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.